Welcome back, everybody. 7:13. We're moving closer to 7:14 on this Saturday morning. Mr. Kuipers, Dave Kuipers, out at Bass Lake in Gowan yesterday evening, sending this particular picture. And I don't even know what this is. Is this some sort of a duck? I don't know that I've ever seen that particular animal in my life. But what is it called? A loon. All right, a loon out of Bass Lake in Gowan. That's what I'm hearing in my ear. But nice looking picture from Dave Kuipers. And also the water that you saw there. Of course, that's a lake, but the waters are a smaller lake. The waters of Lake Michigan, though, not churned up over this weekend nor the next several days, as we don't have any big wind makers moving through the Great Lakes. That's some good news. Back down on that erosion situation, at least for the time being. And winds are becoming a little bit breezier along the lakeshore as we speak right now, with a cold front that is passing through. We've introduced a lot more clouds and even some rain showers, not so much to Grand Rapids yet, but they will be shortly. And already into Holland, areas like South Haven, Muskegon, a light pattern of rain knocking the mercury down. Look at that, a more raw day. Is that a word? A raw day? Yeah, that's what it's going to be versus that 66 and full sunshine occasion from yesterday, or at least close to it. Did have a little bit of cloud cover that come in there for like an hour. Did you notice that late afternoon in Grand Rapids yesterday? But then it went away. We got back into sunshine and we did climb pretty high. 51 if we're lucky today. We'll spend a lot of hours in the 40s here this morning and early afternoon. Rain amounts are not going to be great. Look at this off the model. We're talking about hundredths of an inch to maybe a tenth of an inch to 1,500ths, perhaps a little bit more. Northern sections, Fremont, Big Rapids there. You can see it checking in off the European model. Got these light showers today. Folks, he's going to be out of here by early this afternoon, but will linger clouds, I think, even into the early evening. There could be a couple breaks for sun or at least bright spots in the clouds as we get into this evening. As we go overnight tonight, clouds will completely go away. It will tank the temperatures. It'll be a cold start on Sunday in the lower 30s, but full sunshine comparable to yesterday and Thursday will help to propel temperatures back to the mid to upper 50s on Sunday. Some additional wet weather early this coming week, perhaps later Monday, perhaps later Tuesday, maybe even later Wednesday. There's three different upper level disturbances that I'm keeping my eyes on. None of them look to produce any major amounts of rain, but maybe the later Tuesday one with some warmer air into the pattern at that time could throw down a thunder shower or two. Cooler pattern, though, too, behind that Wednesday, that last weather disturbance, is going to be a discharge of some colder air out of Canada, and that's going to keep us in the 40s. I've got, 47 Thursday, 46 Friday. That's probably too warm even. You just tend to keep it a little bit on the higher side to protect against the models going back a little bit milder, considering the averages by later next week will be in the mid-50s. So we'll keep an eye on that. There's potential for a pretty cool phase there heading into next weekend. You can see those showers working in from Lake Michigan as we speak. We're talking about 30, 45 minutes before they reach Grand Rapids. They'll be sticking around for several hours, but by early this afternoon, sweeping out of here. We're still dealing with clouds, though, into early this evening, and temperatures, they will be chilly, upper 40s to around 50 degrees today. We do fall off tonight under those clear skies, and there's nothing on the model for tomorrow. Brody, you know what nothing on the model means? It means sunshine and great weather on Sunday. Upper 50s, a little bit milder early week before the cooler air arrives Thursday, Friday.